H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Today we are going to see JavaScript executor. So what is this JavaScript executor? You may ask me why again JavaScript is coming to picture, because we are able to successfully click everything, or we are able to automate all the pages. Okay, so the thing is, actually initially even Selenium 1, if you see most of the Selenium 1 code is based on JavaScript only. So how this JavaScript generally works, we discussed already. JavaScript is kind of a client side validations we need to do. That means generally when you have somebody have any validations, whether your format of the email is correct or something you are want to display to the user, some warning or some message, those kind of cases generally JavaScript is used. Okay, but actually if you see the older Selenium, which is Selenium 1 and all, generally JavaScript was frequently used. Why? Because even our normal operations, they did few of the things with JavaScript only. Okay, so indirectly you are executing your JavaScript on your browser. That way you are actually doing like a normal user, but it is actually not a native way of doing. Native way means how do we really go to the application and click on that. So whenever you click what happened, it actually makes a native call, which is the operating system call to click on your particular application and all. But JavaScript doesn't do that way. How JavaScript works is, it is again kind of a JavaScript is also like another scripting language where it works on the browser directly. Okay, so whenever you do have a case where actually your normal actions doesn't work, or so few of the normal pages, especially how to deal with your scrollers. If you see your scrollers in general, for example, let me open one of the website. Okay, see this guy. Suppose we have downloads here. Where it is, here it is. Okay, if you see this page, right, it is actually a big page, correct? Now let's say for one of the test case I want to scroll and see how things are going. Okay, how do we scroll? Do we have any of the XPath for the scroller? Can we generate? No, because scroller is not part of your application. Scroller is part of your browser. So based on your HTML length, it automatically adjusts, correct? So whenever you do those kind of things, what happens is normally you can't do with your Selenium. Okay, so WebDriver, generally we don't have the scroller or something like this one. Okay, for example, your application has scroller, we can do. This is a browser scroller. Okay, suppose your application, some controls you have, those scrollers are available. You might see that scroller as a HTML, but not the browser scroller. Okay, but not the browser scroller. So these cases, what happens is actually, these we cannot really perform with your normal Selenium WebDriver. Okay, so these kind of cases, wherever you want to actually deal with the browser directly, this JavaScript is useful. And also, if suppose due to any of the reason, any of the control is not behaving like normal script is not working on that, you can try with JavaScript. Okay, so what happens is the same click operation is performed by JavaScript. Okay, so that is also possible here. But don't think that it is actually a direct, actually you could use directly JavaScript for anything. No, use that only as an alternative. Remember that. But yes, few of the cases we use JavaScript very effectively. First thing is, as I said, scrollers. Generally scrolling, we don't have anything in Selenium WebDriver where you need to scroll your browser. Okay, so that use JavaScript. Similarly, if you want to actually move a particular element into view in the sense, for example, if you see this page currently able to see only these controls, whatever we are seeing, but this I'm unable to see, which is at the end. Okay, I don't want to perform it. I just want to see whether this particular guy is then available or not. I want to bring this to my view. That means I want to scroll down in such a way, actually it comes here and display this particular element. Okay, so in this case, it is not there. JavaScript, in our Selenium, we have learned that nothing is there to really bring it to display. We have is displayed, which can check whether that particular element is displayed or not. But we can't really bring particular element into display using our Selenium. So those kind of scenarios generally useful executing when you are executing using JavaScript. Why? How this JavaScript is works is very simple. Whatever be the whether you scroll down or bring it to the view, there are actually JavaScript code which you can do. And using that JavaScript code, you give a JavaScript code to the JavaScript executor in Selenium WebDriver. That JavaScript executor, what it does is it executes that JavaScript on your browser. Okay, so that way you'll be seeing all that. But you may ask me, do we need to learn JavaScript for this? Yes, if you want to master it. No, if you want to use it for only for few purposes. Why? Because these are the common purposes which we will get everywhere. Even you can Google it out. And also in my document itself, I given all the possible combinations we use JavaScript. So that is enough for you. Okay. But if you want to really go depth and want to do more things, yes, you can learn little bit of JavaScript and play with it. Okay. So let's see that today. Any questions so far, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So, sir, if some element is not in the view, we cannot do find element on it also?
Find element will find that particular element in the page or page, correct? Can you bring it to the
whether view? Or not it is whether or not it is in the view.
Yes, that's what I'm telling. Find, what find element will does? It will check whether or it will find the element in the page or not, correct?
Yeah.
So, but can it bring it to the view? For example, as I said here, you may initially, whenever the pages gets loaded, where it will show, this will show here like this, correct?
Yeah, it cannot bring to view. That is
yeah, true. that is the reason. So whenever you have these kind of cases, we need to use this. I'm not doing any action. I just want to bring it that into the my view. That's it. For example.
Yeah, right. But sir, can it actually find? I get your point.
No, but
can
remember, it find? Remember, whenever you say find element and click, it may directly come and click here.
Oh, it can. Okay.
Yeah, it can also. Okay, it can click even when that element is not there. But few of the times, what happened depends on the application. If the few of the times, if the element is not actually visible, it may not click also. Okay, so again, that depends how the, as I said, different backend technologies people develop, because we can automate anything, whatever be the technology they developed in the background. For us, we just need a web page, correct? That way.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is how it is. And here, as
Srinivas, to bring the web element into the view, it needs to be scrolled down, right?
Scroll down or scroll left. For example, this is scroller only down is there. What happens if I have right scroller or left scroller also?
Right? Yeah. So for that also the JavaScript edit.
Yes, that helps. Okay. Why? Because JavaScript has the capability to locate each and every element in your page. Same JavaScript also use the same DOM only. Okay, nothing else. It also use the DOM only, document object model only, to get into that element. But only difference is it actually works as a programmatical way in such a way your browser control will be taken care of by JavaScript. For example, if you want to click on particular element, your JavaScript also can do that. Okay, so that way.
Yeah.
Okay. So whatever we don't have in the Selenium WebDriver, you can perform with JavaScript. Commonly, scrollers we don't have in Selenium because it is not a real web control for us. It is a page control on the browser, correct? Not on the application as such.
Yeah,
that way. Okay, so that way. Okay, let's see. And it is very simple, guys. So how it will be executed is there is a actually JavaScript executor class in Selenium WebDriver. Okay, what this takes, see this guy, JavaScript executor equal to JS equal to, you just need to assign your driver by typecasting it. You may ask me, what is this? You are assigning driver as a JavaScript executor. Simple. Your driver will be typecasted as a JavaScript executor. Indirectly, whenever you use this statement, what this becomes is your driver itself will become a JavaScript executor. Now, what is that executor do? It will just execute JavaScript on your page. What is the statement? See here. Now what happens is execute script is the command which you can execute your JavaScript. Now, if you see whatever you give within your execute script is your JavaScript. JavaScript follows the similar syntax like Java. Okay, nothing big about it. It is similar syntax like Java. However, as I told, this also follows the document object model because your page is end of the day it is a DOM only. Okay, this also follows the document object model. This is how you do. So only two things. You need to actually create your JavaScript object using your JavaScript executor object. Then you have a method called execute script, which actually executes your JavaScript on the browser. Simple. Okay, that is the only thing you are going to do. Now let's see this guy. So if you see here, generally this JavaScript executor has two methods, execute asynchronous script and execute normal script. So we don't use this guy. Okay, so why? Because this asynchronous script doesn't really look for whether the page is loaded properly or not. It will check whether that particular HTML is there and then immediately it will do the action. We don't want like that because our applications generally we ensure that the page is loaded first, then only we perform, because we need to really perform like a real user. How do you ensure real user do? We will wait until the page is loaded, then only we go and do some action, right? We don't immediately do while the page is half loaded. Okay, so that way. So that is the reason we generally don't use this approach. So one is execute script. What this does, simple. Whatever be the JavaScript you give, it will get executed. Okay, that's how it is. Generally, JavaScript works as a functions most of the cases. And few of the cases, it will return values also. Okay, it will return values also. For few of the cases, no, it won't return. We will see the common values are returned. Boolean, long, string, list, web element, it will return something like this one. Okay, so but based on the JavaScript you are giving, you will see whether it is returned either Boolean or string or whatever it is. For example, how do you first initialize your JavaScript executor is by creating your JavaScript executor object, something like this one. So as you see here, you are not using any new here. You are actually typecasting your driver itself as a JavaScript executor. Okay, so that means your driver itself has the capacity or capability to run as JavaScript, run JavaScript if it actually typecasted as JavaScript executor. Simple. Now execute script and you will be giving the script and then arguments. What is these arguments are? These arguments are nothing but your web elements on the page, on which web element you want to try perform particular action. So the script will define the action whatever you perform. Okay, that is how it is. So here I given the common code snippets of JavaScript which we use. Okay, if you want beyond this, you can try it out on Google or you can learn few of the basics of JavaScripting and do. Okay, so that way you can do. So, and it is, as I said, it is not mandatory you will be learning the JavaScript for this one. These are all the common things what I given, and beyond this generally we don't use. If you really want to perform more, yes, you can learn it and try it out. Okay, so that way it will be. Now see here, the first one is, if you
could
want
you please to tell. Sorry, sir, could you please tell what is JavaScript executor?
JavaScript executor is nothing but
it's a class or?
No. It is actually a class only, but however, your driver will be converted as that JavaScript executor object. Now, your driver has the capability to execute the script. Simple. Okay. So now this guy, okay. JS means JavaScript executor object, whatever I created here. See this guy. Okay, now we have a method called execute script which does that. Now, first thing, same thing for the browser. If I want to actually refresh the page, the JavaScript is history.go0. If you want to refresh the page, normally what we do, browser driver dot. Okay, then how do we refresh? How do we navigate refresh normally? Navigate. All that refresh, right? But here we use this way also. Okay, so using JavaScript you can do this way. Similarly, if you want to actually fetch the current URL, what we generally do, driver.getCurrentURL. Okay, for that one, see return document.url. What is this document is? Document is refers to the current page it is loaded. As I said, this also follows the DOM, document object model. So, but the current page always here treated as a document. Okay, so document.url. URL actually what happens? Whenever you say document.url, it returns a value. So that is the return reason here. You have a JavaScript as written. Like our Java, JavaScript also use return statement only to return any value. Okay, so now this will return URL. I am converting that URL into string. So that way you will get the URL as a string here.
Can you explain this again? How you're getting that document? I mean, it's a built-in method?
Yeah, it is actually not built-in method. Document is actually referring to your current page on the browser in JavaScript.
Okay,
so current page on your
same as history.
Yeah, same. Okay, which is nothing but actually this is equivalent to our driver way, driver dot get current URL. Okay, so now this is the JavaScript to get your document URL, because URL always, whenever you say return document.url, it will return you the value. What is the return value we need to capture? And this is a URL. URL means a uniform resource locator, which is nothing but your website URL. Okay, now you are converting into string and I'm getting that in a string value. Simple. Okay, that is a common thing. Similarly,
so it was not in string, sir.
It is actually URL. URL is nothing but uniform resource locator, which is there in Java or JavaScript also. Okay, which is actually the real network URL value. Okay, what we generally call this as URI or URL, this one. Okay, it is not a string in general.
But in WebDriver,
it is string. Why? Because in WebDriver, you have actually a constructor which takes both string and URL. So when you string, it will automatically convert that into URL internally. Okay.
And so no argument we are giving. You said there are two things, right? Script and argument.
No. It is not for, again, not for each one. Arguments generally we give for web elements only. But this is just a page. I am not looking into any particular web element. Correct?
Okay.
That is the case here. We don't need to really give argument here, because these are all the things which are on the page level only, not at the element level. Mm-hmm. Okay. Similarly, if you want to press the title, so generally we have driver.getTitle, get page title. So here you have document.title. As I said, document is nothing but your driver here, page. Okay. So return title, it will give you the title. Similarly, see this.
So, sir, a document means it's a browser.
No. That is a HTML page, whatever it is loaded on the browser is document. It is treated as a document.
Okay.
So it is treated as a document. So similarly, I got the title here. Okay. Now, if I want to enter, a value into a particular web element, see that this is what here. So this is your argument, which is web element. What is this user ID? See this guy. In this web element, I want to assign a value, which is nothing but I am setting input value in my Mercury username and password. So in that case, arguments of zero. What is this arguments of zero is? The first web element which appears here. So it is, suppose if you are using more than one element, for example, user ID 2, this will become argument of 1. Okay, generally we don't use more than one argument, because we always deal with single web element only, not multiple web elements. Okay, that way. Okay, so now if we see here, arguments of zero means take the first web element, then set the value of that web element to Mercury. Simple. Okay, similarly, password also same. I take in the password here as a web element, set that value of password to Mercury. So that means the value of that particular field will be assigned as Mercury indirectly. It will type the value Mercury there. Here also it will type the value Mercury. Okay. For that, what we generally use in WebDriver, driver.findElement and
send keys
is the one we use here. Without send keys, you can use this way. But okay, can I use only this way approach? No, don't use it until it is necessary, because normal approach we always go with WebDriver only. Only in peculiar cases, for example, due to any other reason your normal send case is not working, you can try as an alternative to this one. That's it. Okay, so that is the reason I'm giving all the possible combinations here. If you see similarly, see here, same thing, whatever I given in the code, even I have in my page also, so you can go through that way. Okay, first thing, fine. Now what happened? I want to get a particular get text value or inner text, which is nothing but get attribute of text or get text. So get text can be get like this, get value, get attribute of value, you can get like this, get attribute of value. Even you can get inner HTML of that particular field. If that particular field is having any of the inner HTML, which is nothing but generally most of the cases inner text, okay, you will get this one also. Okay, so this one equivalent to your get text, this one equivalent to your get attribute of value, this one equivalent to your get attribute of your inner text. Okay, so that way you will use it. And advantage for this one using get text is generally your get text works only when that particular element is in visible mode. Generally, if it is not visible, sometimes it won't work. But in JavaScript, it won't look for visibility. It will get that text from anywhere in the browser. So that is the advantage of using this one. Okay. In few cases, you might see the behavior.
Can you use what is the text and password?
Sorry.
What is the document? What is the text and password?
One of you, please.
Can we use document.txt here instead of arguments?
No. Document.txt is not there. See, you're looking for document.txt when you give the complete page of your text you want to capture. No, right? You want to capture for a particular element only.
Okay.
So that is the reason I use here my particular web element. Then I'm using the text. If you use document.txt, what will happen? It will get the full document text. What do you do with that?
Okay. Got
that
it.
Way. Okay, so that way.
And so what will be the text of user password?
One of you, please. One of you, please. Okay.
So what will be the text of user password? What do we mean by text?
Okay, so text means actually whatever be the text value this particular field has, and it is not guarantee every time you will have this value. Generally, value is the one. So text is sometimes what happened whenever you assign anything, it will be there. Okay, let us see. For example, see here, I entered Mercury. Okay, let us observe what is the text. If only if that attribute is there, only it will return, otherwise it won't. See here, no text, only name is there. Okay, but your value may be your Mercury once it is there, because the value generally assigned. Suppose if there is no value also, it will be null if there is no value also. Okay, that way. So generally these three are the common things we use: inner HTML, text, value. Inner HTML is nothing but kind of the text whatever you read between the HTMLs. For example, you have a div element where you have multiple tags under this, you want to read that, then in that case you could use inner HTML. Okay, so for example, see here, this guy, see this font is having this much length text right here, this one and this one. If you want, you could use the inner HTML for this font. It automatically fetch you that way.
So what is the inner HTML in this case?
The same thing. What is the answer? It is equivalent to text only. Whatever it is equivalent to text, whatever you are getting displayed within your HTML tag. That's it. And it can take even the children tag also. You're not audible.
Well, inner HTML means it should have a parent and child relationship.
Yes, it is actually not only parent. Suppose see this guy. Suppose here font is having this text, right? So this text is actually part of here. So generally inner text will get you all the text under that particular parent, which is equivalent to kind of dot we use, right? That way. Okay, so the text between your HTML is generally treated as inner HTML. That way it is equivalent to like text only most of the cases. Okay.
So why are you giving for the your username that inner HTML? Why not password?
You can use anything. It is up to you. Yeah. I'm just fetching for one sample field. That's it.
But each argument will be having parent and child. sir, each argument, like for example, the password will be having the parent or child. So for even for
obviously,
that also we can
see, again, it is not guarantee that every field will be having text, every field will be having value, every field will be having inner HTML, right? It is up to you how the field appears on the page. Okay, I just used it as a sample thing here, simple. Okay, nothing else.
Okay, so in this user password will not be having the parent child, so you didn't mention inner HTML there?
It is up to, see, I just gave you a sample example. You could use anything there. If inner HTML is there for that particular web element, it will get, otherwise it will give you null.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I just used an example. I just given as a syntax.
Okay, sir. And the key value, every time you give as argument zero only for all the things?
Yeah.
Or,
why? Because
the password will be one.
That's what I was telling. Why? Because we use only one web element at a time. If you use multiple web elements, you can use half one also. But I don't want to do that because generally we always target for one particular web element, right? Not multiple web elements.
Okay.